Hello guys, and Mal here from Paris and Baz Real Estate. We're coming back to you again with our regular segment of Paris and Baz Cast, where we have a weekly new guest speaker. This week we're joined by Sabine Akbani, the New South Wales Sales Manager from Before You Bid. They specialise in building and pest reports. So hello Sabine, welcome on the show.
Thank you very much.
We're very excited to have you on board. There's a lot of questions that we've had about the topic of building and pest reports. So we're going to jump straight into it.
It'll be pretty valuable insights for our audience out there. So Sabine, just a bit of an introduction about yourself, about your company.
So I'm the State Sales Manager in New South Wales for Before You Bid. We are a panel with about 70 inspectors, and we manage building pest inspection reports and strata reports for vendors. So agents usually get that prior to the sale just to make it easier for their buyers to go through open homes or auctions and bid, you know, with having all the information ready.
Right. So basically, what's the benefits for the vendor in obtaining these reports upfront?
Yeah, so there are actually a lot of benefits, to be honest. Like, for example, in a building and pest report, if a vendor gets that done prior to the sale, they are finding out any issues the property may have. And they, if they wish, they can fix those problems. And for example, let's take an example. If there are termites found, then the vendor can actually exterminate those termites prior to the property going to market, as opposed to finding these issues, you know, when the campaign's live or, you know, during the cooling off period, which can really derail the sale. So having a report ready really saves your sale, to be honest.
Ready up front. So normally the buyer gets a report, but in this instance, the report's readily available.
Also for the agents, I think it's a great opportunity because they are armed with all the information in the report. There's no surprises because if there's a last minute buyer who goes and gets his own report, then it's like a surprise to the agent. He has no idea what's going on, and he could be your highest bidder, and there you go. Like, there's issues, and you know, you can't really manage that towards the end of campaign.
So it's basically transparent from day one. The agent knows what's involved with the property, and the buyer knows from day one before they put the 0.25 or the 10% at auction.
Because a lot of the times we have seen that properties do, when they have gone into cooling off, the building report comes in with a significant defect and they can no longer proceed, which means that they do end up losing their 0.25%. So it's now a matter of having these reports done early. It does save them that, you know, $2,000.
And it leaves a sour taste in the buyer's...
And I've had agents who've done these reports prior to auctions, and last minute a buyer has come in from overseas and said, okay, I'm interested, I want to bid, but do you have a report? And they're like, yeah, here you go, this is the report. Yeah. We send them the link, they download the report straight away. And I've had agents who have said that the buyer, the last bidder who came in randomly last minute, the previous bidder was bidding at 680, and because he had the report, the other one, he actually ended up buying the property for 735. Wow. So that's like an extra amount for, you know, the vendor.
And you're basically getting the extra confidence. And
you're basically, as an agent, you are protecting the price of the property for your vendor by having it ready.
Because at the end of the day, the buyer's going to find out when he does his own building and pest what's going to any defaults.
So I guess the conversation we were having previously was that a building and pest report, like when you do purchase a car, a secondhand car, you get an opinion from a mechanic. So this is a similar scenario in a property that you're purchasing. So you're getting a qualified person go through the property, provide their independent opinion on what could be defective or that needs to be fixed. So that's really, really
great
to see.
That's exactly right, because buying a car, you don't just buy it because it's good looking, although I would do that because I like good looking cars. But you have to go and get it checked mechanically. Otherwise, you know, you're getting into something you have no idea. So it's the same with the houses. Get it checked, be prepared. If there's any issues, fix it for your buyers and make it easier for them to go through your own homes.
Convenience. So talking about convenience, your model is a leading model in New South Wales, and the reason why is that it is the cost-effective model. So can you tell us a little bit more about how it works?
Yeah, so we do have really cost-effective models for buyers and vendors. So it is $49 for building and pest only for both parties, and $29 for strata. There is a successful charge on top for the buyers if they are successful in buying the property. And if, let's say, there's no successful buyer, then that second charge discounted price is charged to the vendor. It just, to be honest, makes it easier for the buyers to go through your open homes and not waste like $500 each property, because realistically a buyer is not looking at one property, he's looking at three, four properties, properties in total.
Yeah.
And having like $500 in, you know, per property, there goes your $2,000. So with us, if you're missing out, there's no worries. We're not going to charge you anything on top. You just pay $49, $29 for strata and you're out the door, no problems. But if you're successful, we charge this the successful buyer charge on top.
And what are the approximate charges for that?
So the successful buyer will pay $450 on top for building and pest, and $220 on top for strata.
For strata, okay. Yeah. So basically the fact that, so this model is only available if the vendor has pre-purchased the report through you guys. So obviously the other arm of your business is that they can approach you direct, and the cost model is different.
Yeah.
But to take advantage of the $49 for a house and
$29 for strata,
That only is applicable if the agency or the vendor has particularly purchased that report
and
to be
prepared.
Distributed.
Prepared prior to sale.
To be distributed to those.
I would just say don't leave it towards the end for the buyers to go get their own report, because, you know, there's surprises in there. And just, you know, back yourself during your campaign. Drive your own campaign. Don't just, you know, be proactive.
And on the back of that, how long does the insurance last on these reports?
That's a really good question, because I get asked this a lot. And so with our reports, there's 90 days insurance from the date of the inspection. However, for the benefits of the vendor and the agents, we leave the report open to be viewed by the buyers if they want after 90 days. Mm-hmm. The only difference is it won't be transferred under their info insurance, because legally no insurance company in New South Wales will transfer it after 90 days.
Mm. So talk us about where that would be handy. So why would they need that sort of insurance to take it to? Is it to address defects?
So realistically, if they have bought a report and if they end up buying the property, that report is under their name,
mm-hmm.
and there is insurance on that report. So they can, if there's any issues they want to get fixed, they can go and get those issues fixed by showing that this report is under their name. So it's just like insured. They're covered that, you know, this report is genuine, legit, and there was an insured inspector who went out and, you know, inspected your property.
Yeah. So I guess from a vendor's point of view, they have the option to rectify those issues first before they go to market, or they can, if it's something that's part of the negotiation, it is something that the owner, the new owner, the buyer, once the report is transferred under their name, they can take to their to have it nominated person to have that fixed.
Yeah, that's correct.
Fixed.
Yes.
Great. Yeah.
There you go.
And in terms of regulation, there's been some recent changes for the building pest and strata.
Yeah, so the regulation changes comes into, so in New South Wales, there were a few changes in August 2016. So what it is basically, as an agent, if there is a building and pest or strata report already done, or you're getting one done for a property, then you have to let the buyers know, disclose the fact that there is a report available to any person who asks for a contract and any interested party for that property. Otherwise, there is a $4,400 fine for the agent.
Wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, basically, just let them know that there is a report available.
If the work's being done.
However, if, let's say, the vendor says, I don't want to get a report done, then you're not obliged to go get one done for the regulation, because that's not the real thing. The fact is, if there is one done, you need to just disclose it to the buyers that there is a report available, and then leave it up to them if they want to buy it or not. Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
And when we get the most commonly asked question is when we get the building and pest report, sometimes 20 pages, 50 pages.
Yeah.
What do we specifically look into that?
Yeah, that's a good question as well. You're asking really good questions. So it is a good question, to be honest, because a lot of buyers, like, for example, if I'm buying a property, I would have no idea what's in that report, right?
Yeah.
That is why when we charge that $49 amount from the buyers, that gives the buyer the facility to call the inspectors. We've got experienced inspectors who are going to run through the whole findings in the report with the buyer. The only thing we would say is, to be honest, realistically, no property comes with zero issues. No property is perfect.
Yeah.
So just, you shouldn't be turned off by few issues in the report. Just keep that in mind, that there will be issues here and there. Just keep 10 to 15K in mind for a repair, you know, repairs and stuff. The major defects to look out for are rising dams or termites, probably.
Yeah.
And then you can just negotiate with the, you know, your, either your agent or the vendor. So that's, these are the things basically that comes up. Mm. And these are the main reasons you need to get one done, mm. because last minute if these issues arise, then you have no time to manage them.
Yeah.
Basically gives you a summary if there's any problem, what we need to rectify, and
yeah.
what needs to be done.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. yeah.
So sort of building, so structural components, would you say, and termite related
So there's could be anything. Could be termites, could be rising dam, could be a broken window, you know.
Yeah.
But we do, as a company, as Before You Bid, we do have this feature, like if, let's say, that it's not a huge problem, and if, like, let's say it's a broken window, then the vendor could fix the problem, take a photo, send it to us, and we fix the report free of cost for the vendor.
Yeah.
Unless it's a big issue where the inspector is obliged to go and view it, mm-hmm. then it's different. But if it's like small issues, which are right, obviously it will be there. No property is perfect.
Yeah.
Then you can fix your problem, take a photo, send it to us, and we fix the report free of cost.
Oh, that's pretty handy.
Yeah, very flexible.
Vendors,
Yeah, very flexible for the agents and the vendors.
I think the main thing is it's very transparent throughout the whole procedure.
Yeah.
And it is providing more information to the buyers to make an informed decision. So when they are looking at purchasing a property, they've got all the information at hand. Obviously there's other aspects of purchasing from a finance perspective, but from an actual physical building perspective, if they have all that information handy, it makes a transaction.
You've got the building and the strata both covered.
Yeah. So I've had friends, as a real life example, to be honest, I've had friends who wanted to bid on a property, and actually it was the Hills area. And the agent, and they went in last minute, and they're like, do you have a report? And the agent's like, no, we don't.
Mm.
And they actually did not even get into it. They did not bid because they do not want to take a risk.
Of course.
With something
if you're
they
putting
have no
10% on the spot, you want to have peace of mind that you've got all your ducks lined up and that you're making the right decision.
Yeah, and I agree, if the report is like $500 per report as a buyer, then I would actually not be bothered for getting it done for every property. But if it's $49, it's worth it. And it's peace of mind for the vendor as well, because obviously if you have something ready and you wanting your buyers to have a great experience going through your open homes, and you want everyone to have a, you know, good, seamless experience, I would say. Yeah. Same for the agents.
Because number of properties fall over in that cooling off period when the building and pest does come through, because it hasn't been done for
it. Yeah, exactly. Mm. And for the agents as well, like if you have the report ready, it's just easier for the buyers to make an informed decision on what they want to do, because everything's out there. You're being transparent. You've got everything out there, and that's it. Leave it on them.
Yeah, all good.
There you go, guys.
Any questions?
Thank you very much. We've got a few people that have joined us on Instagram and
Facebook.
Wow, I'm famous. There you go. Hello to everyone that's watching. Really appreciate your time. And do send us any questions that you may have afterwards. We'll still have Sabine with us in the office, so we're more than happy to answer any questions. So this is pretty much it.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for having me. That's really good initiative. Thank you so much.
So for those of you that do tune in for next week, we will be joined by a home automation company called Liferoom. So Terence Chung from Liferoom will be joining us to talk about home automation and how to retrospectively put that put that in a property that is already built, and how you can do that for a property that's being built as well. So obviously home automation with Alexa, Google Home, and a lot of the other technologically advanced options that are coming out, it is quite a topical issue. So that's something that we'll be bringing to you next week. So do join us next Thursday at 3 p.m. And we've got a few other exciting guest speakers lined up as well thereafter. Thank you so much for your time once again, and we will look forward to seeing you next time.
Bye.
Thank you, guys. See ya.